Welcome back to SnowRunner on Hard Mode. At the end of the last episode, we completed the Essentials mission and reached rank 5, which unlocks some more upgrades. Of particular interest is the small roof rack for the Chevy, which doesn't hold any repair points but does give us 40 litres of extra fuel, which provides a safer buffer for longer trips. In hard mode, when you buy fuel trailers or add-ons which can hold fuel, they're empty. So we'll need to find a fuel trailer to fill the roof rack carriers. With the fuel topped up, we can take a bit of a road trip to find a few upgrades here on the Smithfield Dam map, then head into Drummond Island to see an old friend. The first upgrade to discover for this trip is the engageable all-wheel drive upgrade for the White Western Star. We can't make use of it yet as we'll need to complete the fixer-upper task to get access to that truck, but once we have it in the fleet with a few upgrades installed, it will likely become our primary vehicle for delivery tasks. Taking the path up the hill will lead us to the freeway gearbox upgrade. Thank you. path back down this side of the hill can be a bit tricky. So again, using low gear and occasional use of the handbrake to lock the rear wheels should let us keep the front of the Chevy pointed down the hill. The next thing to pick up on this trip is the raised suspension upgrade for the White Western Star, which is located along the shoreline. path back to the main road up the hill is deceptively bumpy and has a few sections with no winch points, so care is needed. Taking this path at night is less than ideal, as I didn't even see the dip here. Thankfully no damage was done, and we have the autonomous winch on board and some trees we can hook onto. Instead of going straight into Drummond Island from here, it's worth taking the time to backtrack slightly and discover the nearby watchtower, as we may not need to send a scout vehicle back this way for some time. Heading into Drummond Island, there are a few tasks along the way we can discover, along with an engine upgrade to suit some of the heavy trucks, which will be useful later on. There are a few bridges on this map we'll need to rebuild, but for now we can cross the river here. I'll pick up the tourist attraction mission and activate it, as it is on our way to our next destination. Crossing to the island can be slow going in the Chevy. With low gear, diff lock, and occasional use of the winch will get us through the mud. Up the hill is a fuel trailer we can fill up from. We used nearly 90 litres of fuel to get here, so we wouldn't have made it without the roof carrier. Now we get to the main reason to make the trip to Drummond Island, the Pacific P-16. The P-16 doesn't need any repairs and is fully fueled, so we can start using it to complete tasks immediately. We'll start by building a couple of the wooden bridges, first for the Support Local Rangers mission, which will require us to head back across the river to pick up some wooden planks. Based on stats alone, the P-16 may not sound particularly special due to its lack of all-wheel drive and being limited to one set of off-road tyres. But those tyres actually perform better than most mud tyres on other vehicles, so don't be too quick to dismiss it. There is a sideboard trailer with wooden planks just past the logging station. Leave the trailer at the fuel station and top up. There's another trailer back at the logging station we can use to pick up the planks for the next bridge. As we don't have a loading crane, we'll need to pay $300 to auto-load two loads of planks. But in my opinion, this is worthwhile, as the alternative is to bring the Fleet Star all the way to Drummond Island, and then have to cross the river using the path we took in the Chevy earlier, as delivering the planks for the Of Bridges and Men mission can only be completed on this side of the river. Thank you. There is still one more bridge to build on this map, which is needed to access the port, but I'll leave that for a later episode. Thanks for watching.